I've been dreaming on in my head like I've seen it. A life worth living is a life with meaning. I'll do what I love till my heart stops beating. I'm feeding this demon. Got a taste, can't erase bitterness in my face. Work a job every day till your dreams fade away. Like a card, never change, play the game that we say. I need a break.
Good afternoon, YouTubers. Thank you very much for joining me today. Yes, I did see this magnitude 4.2 earthquake this morning there by Cobb Mt. 4:57 a.m. local time, 68 people said they felt this earthquake. I've been trying to track down seismic monitors from that location, and there's many of them, but I don't have access. Many of you that have followed me through the years know that I used to live up there. The geysers started to dry up, so they started pumping water into the ground so that they would continue to have the geothermal energy that they sell and transfer to the Bay Area and different parts of the U.S. Now here's the location, and look what's right next to where this 4.2 earthquake occurred. Yep, water injection. They started the water injection in the early 1980s and created earthquakes, and it was kept all hush hush. Yep, they even knew back then that earthquakes can often be created by man. I am sure that there was damage caused by this earthquake. This earthquake was shallow. It was about 1,400 feet below sea level. Of course, you know, all earthquakes are measured from sea level. And up over here is Clear Lake. A lot of the homes, in fact, I lived in one up there on Cobb Mt, have stone foundations. Yeah, stone put together with cement, unreinforced. It was reported over a very large area, in fact, all the way by Lake Tahoe. Intensity level 2 by Glenbrook. San Francisco Bay Area down by Oakland. Let's see what we got. Doesn't show. Intensity level 1. Vacaville, intensity level 5. Up there on Cobb Mt, Middletown. Intensity level 5. Yeah, you guys better check your gas lines, your water lines, things like that. Intensity level 5 means felt by most people, some breakage of dishes, windows, and plaster. Tall objects probably fell over. I tried downloading the data from two different monitors. I figured this one here from Mendocino County would have been the best. And then I got another one here by Petrolia, California. And I'll go back another 4 hours and I'll show you what happened here. I'll bring it down. Yeah, just before the earthquake, you can see there was probably one right here. They shut it all down. Probably right after that earthquake that occurred. Yeah, this would have been a very good site to get the data from. Up over here at the top is Petrolia. You can see we got an earthquake. That's probably it right there. And I'm going to try and download it. And then down here is the Mendocino. See, it's all blank. Let's go back another 4 hours. Yep, going back another 4 hours, and you can see the data's all been wiped for Mendocino County. USGS is reporting 51 earthquakes in the last 24 hours in this location, Cobb Mt. The most recent, a 0.5. A 1.2, a 0.4, a 0.8. Let's go all the way down. Oh my goodness. Yeah, we got a 2.2. How many since this? Well, yeah, there's just how many before? Oh my goodness. Yeah, it makes me mad. Makes me extremely angry. There's the location. Let me make it bigger. Of the 4.2. And yeah, the red ones are all the recent ones. Yeah, we got a 1.5, a 1.6. Yeah, a lot of them. Looks like the largest would have been the 4.2 since then. Yeah, you poor people. Up over here by Clear Lake, which is part of this volcanic chain, is Mount Conocti. When I lived there, let me bring this down, which was over here by Jago Bay. Actually, I lived in a lot of areas over there. There would be bubbles that come up and gases that come up, and you'd see fish floating that were dead. The Lake County Sheriff's Department there in Lakeport, I believe it is, has a paper about earthquakes and damage that could happen there in the county. And at the bottom of the paper, they talk about Mount Conocti volcano. Mount Conocti is part of the Cascade Range, a chain of volcanoes that run from Northern California into British Columbia. Mount Conocti is one of 16 areas in California is identified as likely to experience volcanic eruption. Recent volcanic deposits dating only a few thousand years ago and the presence of geothermal resources suggest an event should be included as an identified threat. The effects of an eruption of Mount Conocti would be similar in nature to those of a significant local seismic event, but may also include significant ashfall, pyroclastic flows, and hot, potentially toxic gas flows. Virtually the entire population of the southern county may be required to relocate until the eruption subsides. Contact and coordination with the adjacent counties of Mendocino, Napa, Solano, Colusa, and Yolo would be required to facilitate traffic and mass care for evacuees. So, intensity level 5 from this earthquake is considered a moderate earthquake felt by nearly everybody indoors, and they would have been woken up. Yeah, and have damage. Historic records indicate that at least 50 damaging earthquakes have occurred since the mid-1880 time period. Now, this is for Lake County. Specific hazards include ground failure in the coastal lowlands, resulting in damage to foundations and utility lines, fires associated with damaged electrical and gas lines, landslides affecting transportation and communication routes, ground rupture, damage to bridges and overpasses. Yep, all for a buck. All to increase your rates of electricity. Make sure that you still have your power running. And even though there's shortages of power there in California, there's the pipeline. Let's see if we can follow it. Well, they got pipelines going everywhere. Well, we got a home over here. Yeah, I'm sure they got damage. Looks like they got solar panels. And here we got Bottle Rock Geothermal Facility, where one of the lines goes up close to. So, what are your thoughts? Did you feel this earthquake? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you for watching my videos, and thank you for subscribing. If you're not a subscriber, please subscribe. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you.